Hi everyone, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to link data between different spreadsheets in Google Sheets. This can be incredibly helpful, especially when you have data that is shared across multiple spreadsheets, but you don't want to waste time manually entering the same information twice or constantly copying and pasting between files. I will also demonstrate how to link data between different tabs within the same spreadsheet. The process is very simple and straightforward. Please keep in mind that this method only works in Google Sheets. It doesn't work in Microsoft Excel. For today's demonstration, I will be using two spreadsheets, which is Job Estimate Tracker and another one is Invoice Tracker. I will show you how to link data from the Job Estimate Tracker to the Invoice Tracker. When you update information in the Job Estimate Tracker, those changes will automatically reflect in the Invoice Tracker. Let's say I want to import customer name from the Job Estimate Tracker into the Invoice Tracker, so I can easily select the customer's name when issuing an invoice after the job is complete. Here is how to do it. First, go to the Customer List tab in the Invoice Tracker. In cell B6, enter the import range formula. Start with quotation mark, go to the Job Estimate Tracker, copy the URL link of the spreadsheet and paste it here. And close with a quotation mark. The second part is called range string. Start with a quotation mark. Enter the name of the tab you want to refer in the Job Estimate Tracker, which is customer list, and then put an exclamation mark and input the range that you want to refer, for example B6 to #100, and then close it with a quotation mark, then press enter. If this is the first time linking these two spreadsheets, you will see a reference error. Just click allow access button and data will appear here. Now, whenever a new customer is added in the Job Estimate Tracker, it will automatically update in the Customer List tab of the Invoice Tracker. Let me show you how it works. For example, if I now add a new customer name in Job Estimate Tracker, when I go to Invoice Tracker, it will appear exactly as I input in the Job Estimate Tracker. You can also customize your trackers by adding additional column. Just remember, if you add a new column, for example in the Job Estimate Tracker, let's say in front of column E, be sure to make the same adjustment in the related tabs like monthly overview. So if you go to monthly overview, you also need to add another additional column in front of column E here, so that everything works the same. The same goes for the Invoice Tracker. For example, if you insert a new column before column E, you will also need to adjust tabs like monthly overview. And customer overview. Outstanding invoice tab as well. To stay aligned. If you want to be able to select a job estimate number in the Invoice Tracker, first you need to create a blank tab, select any cell, input the import range formula, start with quotation mark, and copy the URL of the Job Estimate Tracker and paste it here. Then the second part is input the name of the tab you want to import the data from. In this case, it's called Job Estimate Tracker. I want to import the Job Estimate Tracker data into Invoice Tracker. Job Estimate Tracker. Input the range of the cells you want to import the data from B6 to column O. All the data from Job Estimate Tracker will appear here. You can rename the tab. Let's call it Job Estimate Tracker. Let's say I want to be able to select the Job Estimate number in this column. First, I need to go to Data, select Data Validation, add rule, select dropdown from a range, select the data range, which is here. And then click OK. From here, I can select the job estimate number from the drop-down list. So you can populate the drop-down for additional rows by dragging the bottom right corner of the cells toward the bottom of the spreadsheet. So that's how you can link data between spreadsheets in Google Sheets. This method is super useful and can really help you streamline your workflow and save time. You can also link the data from your job estimate tracker to other spreadsheets such as project cost tracker if you use the project cost tracker together with a job estimate tracker and invoice tracker. Thanks for watching until the end. I hope you enjoyed this video and found this video helpful. Please leave a comment below and let me know your thoughts. Thank you for watching and see you in the next video.